for me personally and honor for inviting Sheikh Taqi Usmani, Chairman IOFI Sharia Board, to deliver his keynote speech. Let me also invite the fellow panelists and commentators to the stage as well. Can we start with Professor Alexey Ivanov? Mr. Mikhail Orlov? His Excellency Sheikh Nizam Yaqubi, Member of the Sharia Board, Mr. Yalan Bedolat, Director General Islamic Organization for Food Security, Kazakhstan, Dr. Imran Ashraf Usmani, Member Board of Jamia Darul Uloom University, Karachi, and I invite His Excellency Sheikh Mufti Taqi Usmani to deliver his keynote speech.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin Khatamun Nabiyyin Wa Imam al-Mursaleen Wa Qaid al-Ghurr al-Muhajjaleen Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in Wa ala kulli man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin My brothers and sisters Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. It is really a great pleasure and honor for me to participate in this pioneering project that is being presented today, not only for discussion but also to take practical measures to implement it. First of all, I would like to point out that when we speak of Islamic finance, some people understand that Islamic finance is restricted to the Muslims only. No doubt, it is. The principles governing Islamic finance are provided by the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Muslims are bound to follow them in each sphere of their life. But so far as Islamic finance or Islamic trade is concerned, its benefits are not restricted to Muslims only. They comprise some principles, guiding principles that are for the betterment of the entire humanity at large. So therefore, it is not Muslims only that benefit from these principles and these values, but it also gives a better solution for the economic affairs throughout the world. Today we see that the human beings have experienced different systems of economy. There has been feudalism, then came capitalism, socialism and communism. But none of these systems could solve the problems of human beings so far as their economic life is concerned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the Holy Quran and the teachings of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has given us a set of principles governing each sphere of life, including economy and finance. These principles are not made by human beings only on the basis of reason, only on the basis of experience, but they are given to us by revelation directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, they aim at the betterment of all humankind, all human beings in this globe. So this is the reason why non-Muslim countries are also interested in practicing according to those principles that are set by the Islamic financial system. For that purpose, in the last year, I think, I was very kindly invited by this university that is for higher studies of law and economy. And when I was in Moscow, Brother Elsie and Brother Krill, they have told me that they are thinking about a product or a project in which they want to use Islamic finance for the food security and for the purpose of exporting grains to the Muslim countries on the basis of Islamic modes of financing. I was very happy to see that they had developed this understanding, and they have formed a forum in which this suggestion was discussed. So I personally advised them to take this product or this vision before a gathering in which all the stakeholders are present and in which this concept may be discussed. And I suggested that it should be given in a conference that is being held by AOFI. Alhamdulillah, it was my dream, and it was alhamdulillah in practice today. Well, I'm happy for that. The basic concept behind this suggestion or behind this product or behind this vision is that food is the basic need of human beings. No person can deny it, be he Muslim or non-Muslim or from any nation. He needs food. But the trade of food in our economic system has been subjected to many manipulations. And when the traders of grain, they come to the market, they act upon their own concepts of earning as much money as they want. And for that purpose, there is a chain of middlemen. There is speculative transactions because of which the food or grains cannot reach the poor people except on a very high price that they cannot afford. So if we act upon the principles given to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and by the Holy Quran, then this gap may be filled and the need for food can be fulfilled through these transactions which are compliant with the basic principles of Islamic finance. And for example, Russia is the biggest exporter of wheat and biggest, some of the big countries that produce grain. So they wanted to use Islamic finance to finance their exports to other countries on the basis of Islamic principles, so that the Muslim countries and in particular the Middle East countries would benefit from this, and they may establish a constant relationship with them to export grain, to distribute grain among the nearby countries and also to the Muslim countries on a fair basis, on an equitable basis, that will be very beneficial for the poor people who need grains. So this is the basic vision. And for that purpose, they have established a kind of relationship between themselves and between some stakeholders and between some companies, that is Swani company. So today we will discuss, inshallah, this unique product, and we will discuss how the pros and cons of the proposal that is before us, and to find out the solutions to the food security problem and for the ambitions of Russia to export grains to the countries, to the Muslim countries through Islamic finance. And I hope that inshallah this session and these discussions will throw more light on the vision that is the subject matter of this session. And I hope that all the participants will contribute to different horizons of the vision, and I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may guide us for that, inshallah. Wa akhiru ta'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.